please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
A market veteran, Ramesh Damani, moderated a panel on valuations and consolidation in the financial space with some of the biggest market voices. He began by asking Nilesh Shah the implications for the global equity and debt markets in our times of Brexit and rising bond deals in America. But lots more interesting takeaways. Do listen in.
If liquidity disappears, it will hit everything, equity market, debt market, even the commercial world. In some sense, 2008 crisis came to India not because Lehman expired, but it happened because banks who had given export credit to our oil marketing companies as well as our importers, those credits were not rolled over. We had to make payment for those credits, and the local companies had to either borrow in dollar, which was not easily available, or fund it from rupee market. That non-rollover of credit took probably $15, $20 billion of liquidity out of system, and that's where we took major pain of 2008. If similar scenario happens, and today we are far more globalized than we were before, there is $80 billion in debt market. We are not part of any indices. These fund managers have taken a call on India. Tomorrow they can take entire $80 billion out. I don't think so. We have capability to manage that without consequence on our market. In equity market, they are probably today about $500 billion. If they take $30, $40 billion, that's again going to have an impact.
That's all they can take out. Market won't allow them to take out more.
No. At least in equity market, there is a self-correcting mechanism. But since we are more globalized and if liquidity disappears, there will be problem.
Utpal, let me come to you. The last 3 years have been what a lot of us call the Goldilocks scenario for the NBFC space. Why has it been Goldilocks? You can explain to our audience. And is it likely to continue in your view?
Right. Last 2 to 3 years, the largest part of the banking system has been handicapped. And hence, it's a clean highway for the NBFCs to take market share away. This is very much like what happened to MTNL and BSNL at different points of time. This was compounded by demonetization, which brought on a liquidity surplus, and that pushed down the short-end interest rates and steepened the yield curve, which is a very good environment for NBFCs to lend. Think of it this way: at one point of time, the marginal cost of NBFCs was lower than the marginal cost for banks. Hence, this was Goldilocks scenario. You had very rapid expansion of your lending book with very healthy NIM. And because you were growing so fast, your NPAs were not yet catching up.
NPAs in this, just for our understanding, better to measure them on a lagged basis, the NPAs?
Absolutely. If you give a loan, then it's not going to become an NPA from the next day.
Correct.
Right? So probably the right way to look at NPAs is NPAs today versus the loan book of maybe 2 years ago. However, the way that most of us financial analysts look at presently is NPAs today divided by the loan book today.
Yeah. Thanks. Ramdev, in the many times I've heard you speak very passionately about value migration, how you made money when you understood what was happening to telecom companies. Are you seeing the same thing playing out in the financial sector? The move from the 80s, the PSU banks to, you know, a plethora of choices now.
Yeah, I mean, I think this is one of the biggest value migration happening for last, say, about 20 years, actually. It started with private licenses being given in 90s. And that time it was very small, the private sector banks, so they couldn't make impact. By 2007, 8, 9, I mean, the size of private sector banks, they started becoming big. And now they have become seriously big. Now they have corroded, they have taken market share of about 25-30%. So I think acceleration of value migration from public sector to private sector is happening now. I mean, and with this kind of event, it is going to further accelerate.
This because, kind meaning the PNB
this event,
imbroglio.
Yeah, it will freeze all the corporate bankers or the babus to underwrite or roll over, and that will ultimately the business will go to private sector side. So and the economy is growing at 7-8%. So the demand for banking services is exploding by the day, and at the same time the appetite to underwrite and appetite to really appraise whatever is the credit risk thrown is not there. So people like HDFC Bank or whatever private sector you have, then you have the NBFCs. They're all beneficiary of this particular trend, and it's a large economy. So the spoil is very large.